guys, Jason here from cricketstoreonline.com, and real quick little review slash video. People have been asking me a lot about what I've got in my kit bag, so that's starting off. We're going to be looking at the Gray Nicolls Legend kit bag. Phenomenal bag. Got two big pockets here in the top where you can put softs, shoes, clothing, hats, anything like that. Okay. Some of the stuff I've got in here, I've got a spring fielding stump. This bag is massive, so you fit just about everything in it. Let's see, I've got my chest guard that I use when I go up against the bowling machine. I don't use it in matches, but I use it when I'm going up against the bowling machine, when I'm clocking it up. Here's a thigh guard to help me with my hamstring pull. I've got a hat in there. Then, let's see, we've got some T20 wraps that you use to put yours, like the clads back covers, or pad covers. So that's that, I've got those in there. I've got a bag with, it's actually a batting glove bag, SS batting glove bag that I've got balls and stuff in. Here is my Kookaburra Players Combi, all-in-one thigh pad. Kookaburra Players On Guard. I've got my Adidas Adipure, two sets of batting gloves. Got my Adidas Adi Power batting pads. They go in there as well. Alright. There's a cone. Put grips on for my buddies and stuff. A baseball glove that's to use during fielding practice when I'm hitting catches to people. This is my shin guard. I wear just on the inside of my front leg because I tend to get inside edges. Don't worry about that though. Here's my Puma IPL Pulse shoes, taking the spikes off because we play on AstroTurf pitches, so I've got studs in there. And my Missouri titanium helmet, and that goes in there. So let's see what else we've got. Right over here, you've got a double back cave, okay? So what we've got in there is we've got, this is my net bat, the one that I use in the nets and against the bowling machine. And also my now old Hammer Odin. The reason it's old is because I've got a slight crack down the bottom here, which I'm not too happy about. Not sure exactly how or when it happened. I did lend the bat to a friend, but I can't blame him. The reason why it's my old bat is because, let me see what we've got behind here. This is my new bat that I'm going to be using. It's a Berserker T20 RS. So that's my new bat. So that's the two bat caves on that side. On this side over here, we've got three little pockets. In that pocket over there, I've got my Abdo Guard. This one over here, this is where I would keep during the game my like things like little extra studs, spikes, some umpire scoring counters, you know, stuff like that. I also chuck my keys and my cell phone and stuff in there. And then in this little container here, I've got my batting inners and sweat guards and stuff like that. So that goes in there. So that's just a little look at that. Then over here, there's a third bat cave there. And this is where we're going to be giving the Gray Nicolls Legend bag a bit of a bad review. I'll get to that in a second. You'll see what I'm talking about. In here, I've got some more fielding aids. This is the little Catch It or Gray Nicolls little fielding bat. It's a foam. Pick on there, makes the ball just fly. I've also got my little ball thrower. I keep it in here because they are quite brittle. They do break pretty easily, so most people normally keep it in the box, but I was tight for space, so I went for putting it in there. So the problem here is with this little third bat cave, alright, is that the bat doesn't fit. You can try all you want with this third bat cave, but as you can see there, the bat doesn't fit in the bat cave. So I don't know if that was done intentionally, but I'd use a regular short handle bat. But you would think that they would at least make it long enough for a long handle bat. But so that's why I don't keep my bat in there. I keep them in the other side, and I keep these fielding aids in there. So that's actually the reason why I'm getting rid of this Legend bag and swapping back to the duplex wheelie, the GM duplex wheelie. The reason is that this bag is massive. It's very big. If you want a huge big traveling bag, something that you can even maybe get your whole team kit in, If you're a wicket keeper and you've got a bunch of wicket keeping gear, then this bag would be very good for you. It's massive, it's very big. One of the pluses is that it has this pull-out carry thing here, so you'll know what I mean. If you're carrying it with this handle here, you're hitting yourself on the leg all the time when you're pulling it. If you've got this one over here, it's really, really handy. But I park my car in the garage, and I've got a small little space next to it that I sort of need to walk out with, and I pull my bag behind me, and this bag is just too wide, so I'm going to the duplex wheelie that's a little bit narrower. And so just, I've got a buddy that I just sold one to, he says it's too small, so we're just going to do a straight swap. And that's a quick look at what I carry in my bag, and also a quick review of the Gray Nicolls Legend kit bag. Oh, and another thing, you're supposed to be able to stand it up, right? But it doesn't really stand up, and then you have this little compartment or door here that if it was standing up, you could then stick your hand in there and pull the stuff out, but never really worked for me, to be honest. So that's just a quick little look at the Gray Nicolls Legend kit bag. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys later. Bye.